We go now to Lora Windsor for her report.
Roger, more than half of the U.S. population by the time they reach their 20s will be infected by the type 1 herpes simplex virus that is responsible for reoccurring cold sores. We spoke with Dr. Stephen Wilson at Redlands Community Hospital to learn about the best ways to treat this painful condition.
The cold sore is the classic lesion that occurs on the lips itself or the borders of the lips. The cold sore is typically occurs from a virus, and it's actually herpes simplex virus. And that particular virus, there's actually two types. There's type 1, which they say kind of occurs above the belt, and then there's type 2, which occurs below the belt. And these are very common viruses that can occur. And the reason why some people actually develop them more tends to have to do with their immunity. If you have more of a weaker immune system, you tend to get them to occur more. And particularly in women, during their menstrual cycles, very common for women during their menstrual cycles to develop a breakout of the herpes virus. You usually feel like a tingling sensation or a burning sensation that might occur first. Then the blisters occur, and then they usually kind of ooze and then they'll crust over. But usually they don't leave any type of permanent type of scar or anything like that. But they do tend to occur usually in the same location. This particular virus, it actually goes into the nerve cell itself, and that's why during a time when there's maybe increased stress, or like I mentioned, a woman that might, during her menstrual cycle, where her immune system might be somewhat down during that time, that particular virus can occur. They last roughly about a 10-day, 14-day period. But it can be quite painful, and obviously can be embarrassing for patients also. And so if you catch it during that early stage, when I mentioned they feel a burning or tingling, actually before the actual blisters occur, you can take antiviral medication. You can take it in an oral form, or you can actually do a topical form. And that actually reduces the replication that occurs of the virus, and actually they can resolve a lot quicker. The prevention is, obviously, if somebody has a cold sore, that means that they are in an active phase where they potentially could infect that other person. So certainly kissing could occur. Even utensils, if you're using those kind of things, or the virus can spread that way. So you want to be careful with hand washing and just the actual exposure itself to that open lesion puts you at risk of developing it. Now, if the cold sore persists, then you need to be concerned about something else possibly going on. Usually you can identify them if you go to your physician. Pretty easy to identify the classic cold sore. But if you have something that is not resolving or going away, then you definitely want to get it looked at, because there are other, you know, potentially even more serious things. You can have a cancer that actually can occur, a skin cancer. So again, the virus would take its course and resolve, and a skin cancer would keep going and might actually require a biopsy. There are other kind of autoimmune type problems. One is called lichen planus. That's another common type of lesion that occurs that we might want to take into consideration if it doesn't resolve within that couple of weeks.
You can't cure HSV or a cold sore, but you can alleviate the pain it causes by avoiding spicy or acidic foods and by following the recommended remedies. For the American Health Journal, I'm Laura Windsor.